In this video, we're going to talk about riding lesson horses, and specifically, how much can you expect to be able to change the behavior of a lesson horse, of a horse that you get to see and ride once a week, or maybe even less. There's three main keys that I want to talk about here. The first is awareness, the second is connection, and the third is consistency. So the first step towards being able to have a better interaction with any horse, whether it's your own horse or whether it's a horse that you're just going to take lessons on, is to have some awareness of what's going on with the horse, how is he feeling, what little signs is he giving you, is he stressed, is he bored, is he maybe uncomfortable, or does he seem like he's just simply not paying attention? But just having some more awareness around what the horse is doing, what might be causing it, and just paying attention to what's going on in the moment between you and the horse is the first step. The second step is looking for a way to establish a connection with that horse. So just look to find what do they like? And this can be as simple as you're grooming them, notice, is there a place that as you're scratching them there, they seem to really enjoy it? Or is there a place that they really don't like to be touched? Or when you're brushing them, is there a stiffer brush you use and they just tense up? They don't really enjoy it that much. Noticing those simple things can go a long way to creating that connection. And even when you go to catch the horse or you go to greet the horse before your lesson, think about trying to connect with them, like actually look at them, see if you can get them to acknowledge you, to just touch your hand with their nose. It's just those little things that can actually make the biggest difference between creating that connection instead of just coming in, you know, giving them a pat, getting on, and just going through the motions of riding. So having that awareness and then looking to establish that connection. And now the third thing is a little bit more of for training, and this is your consistency. So you want to be obviously as consistent as possible with your pressures, with your timing, and with your rewards. And this consistency is really important because a lot of times horses in this situation don't necessarily get a lot of consistency, but you can train and you can change the responses of a horse within minutes. So horses learn really fast. A lot of lesson horses, even though they may be kind of checked down in a sense, if you can get those first steps and you can get them connected and paying attention, you can start to change their behavior really quickly in the beginning of that lesson. And we've all seen horses that react differently to different people. So you can absolutely become the person who is able to have the horse move forward freely, is able to get the horse to move off of your light aids, even if other riders in the barn are struggling. And you can change that horse's responsiveness to, say, the go forward cue within just the first few minutes of your ride when you have the consistency of your timing and of your pressures and rewards. And then, of course, also to a point when you have the physical skills to be able to be that consistent in whatever it is you're asking for, whether it's simply a nice transition up into a trot or if it's something that's maybe more advanced than that. Of course, it's important to have reasonable expectations for these horses. So if this is a horse that's in a lesson program and maybe he's being ridden by a different rider every day or even several different riders, you know, during each day, you can't necessarily expect that he's going to always be exactly the same when you come out to ride. Meaning you can't expect that he's necessarily going to make that progress as quickly as a horse that maybe you were just working with, because learning happens through reinforcements. And if he's still being reinforced, whether it's through accidental releases or poor timing, but if he's still being reinforced for some of those undesirable behaviors, maybe it's going slow, maybe it's pulling to the center of the arena, whatever it is, if he's still getting that reinforcement other times when you're not there, he's probably gonna try it again, try those behaviors when you come out to ride him. But As I mentioned before, we can change behavior really quickly. And when he has that consistency of knowing what responses you expect and what responses you're looking for, it can get easier with each ride. And it can only take those first few moments of, think about it as you're just kind of telling the horse, look, this is how we do things, this is what I expect. But having those reasonable expectations that the behaviors are gonna come back, there's other people working with him, he might be getting reinforcement for this somewhere else, he might be almost thinking this is the right thing to do with someone else, so I just have to come in each time and be very clear and consistent about what I expect and what response I'm looking for when I give this cue or when I apply this pressure. Finally, remember to find the balance between being very kind and understanding of that horse and looking for that connection, but also being as firm and assertive as you need to be to establish that relationship and to establish the correct responses that you need from the horse when you're there and when you're interacting with them. And going through these principles and remembering just this awareness and then connection and then your consistency will go a long way to helping you have a better ride and a better lesson on the horses that you use. Now I want to hear from you. Leave a comment below and tell me one thing you will do differently the next time you interact with your lesson horse. Also, starting October 11th, I'm hosting a free workshop to discover the three most commonly taught myths in riding and how to find ease in your riding and a better relationship with your horse. This workshop will feature an online video clinic, live Q&As, and worksheets, and it's all free. Use the link below to join in.